Once upon a time,
I wish,
in a far-off kingdom,
more than anything,
lived a young lady,
life,
a sad young lad, a
rich
and a childless baby.
More than life,
I wish,
with his wife,
more than anything,
more than love, I wish the king is giving a festival.
More than life,
I wish to go to the festival.
More than riches.
Oh.
father and mother in a baking accident. Well, at least that's what he believed. He was eager to have a family of his own, and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
We have sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door.
Go to the wood! and we're jarring with those you made as the fools of the festival and mortify the prince.
The carriage is waiting.
We must be gone.
Hunting jacket.
Six beads.
I wonder if they are.
Witches' beads? We'll take them with us.
No, you are not to come.
I know you are fearful of the woods at night.
No, the spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
No, no, the spell is on our house. We must lift the spell together. The spell is on our house.
No, you are not to come, and that is fine. Now, what am I to return with?
You don't remember? The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as
and
blood.
And so the baker reluctantly set off to meet the enchantress' demands. As for Cinderella,
I still wish to go to the festival.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood,
to go to the
hair is yellow as
corn.
Exchange her for a sack of beef.
Well, I... Come along, Milton.
Milky White, there are spirits here.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so grandmother would have something good to make her strong.
And where might your grandmother live?
A good quarter of a league further in the woods. Her house ends under three large oak trees.
Look at that flesh, pink and plump. Hello, little girl. Tender and fresh, not one lump. Hello, little girl. This one's especially lush, delicious. Hello, little girl. Once you're rushed, you're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time.
Mother said straight ahead, not to the lake or be misled.
But slow, little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. The birds are singing sweetly. Birds crisp, aging buds, and something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious carnality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe what you feel when you're talking to your meal.
Mother said not to stray, still suppose a small delay. Granny, my life, a fresh bouquet. Goodbye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, little girl.
Magic? What kind of magic? Magic that defies description.
Oh, my mother would.
You'd be lucky to exchange her for a set of beads.
How many beads? Six.
Five. We can't part with all of them. We must save one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say each bead was worth about a pound at the very least.
Could I buy my cow back someday?
Well, possibly.
Good luck, fair young lad.
I guess this is goodbye, old pal. You've been a perfect friend. I hate to see us part, old pal. Someday I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, it won't be on a plate.
Take the cow and return home.
I was trying to be helpful.
Magic beans? We've no reason to believe they're magic. Are we to dispel this curse through deceit?
No one would have given him more for this creature. Besides, we did him a favor. At least they'll have some food.
Five beans?
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in between. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe there will be magic, who knows? Why you do what you do, that's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look at her, she's crying.
If the thing you do is pure in intent, if it's meant and it's just a little bent, doesn't matter.
Yes.
No, what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is the size. Only three more tries and we'll have our prize. When the end's in sight, you'll realize if the end is right, it justifies the beat.
Take the cow and return home. I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued his search for the cake as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest. And when the enchantress paid a visit, she called for
Rapunzel!
Certain that no wolf crosses your path.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day.
know what you need, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? It's a cloak. What's a cloak? It's a joke. It's a stupid little cloak. And a cloak is what you make it, so you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so the baker, with newfound determination, went after the Red King. As for the little girl, she was very surprised to find her grandmother's cottage door standing wide open.
Oh dear, how uneasy I feel. Perhaps it's all the sweets. Good day, grandmother. My grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
But grandmother, what big eyes you have.
The better to see you with, my dear.
But grandmother, what large hands you have.
The better to hug you with, my dear.
Oh, grandmother, what a terrible big wet mouth you have.
The better to eat you with, my dear.
And scarcely had the wolf said this than with a single bound he was devouring the little bird. Well, it was a full day of eating for both. And with his appetite appeased, he took to bed for a nice long nap.
Odd, that grandmother has a mighty snore. I wonder where the little one is. Eating, no doubt.
Bleh.
Or E10. Grandmother, ah! What is that in the corner of your mouth? Looks to me to be a piece of... Aha! I'll get the cloak from within your stomach!
Excited.
that.
Are you certain?
Yes. Maybe Granny will make me another from the skins of that wolf.
Thank you.
And so the baker, with the second article in hand, feeling braver and more satisfied than he had ever felt, ran back through the woods. As for the lad Jack.
Only adults would exchange a cow for beans.
Mother, no!
Come in without summer for you!
Little did they know that those beans would grow into an enormous stalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Are you all right, miss?
Oh, yes. I just need to catch my breath.
What a beautiful gown you're wearing. Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Aren't you the lucky one? Why ever are you in the wood at this hour?
Oh no, the prince, help!
Hide, hide!
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown pass by?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see a... this way, sir.
Into the woods and out of the woods and
giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high and you look below at the things you left and the things you know, little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high and you're all alone in a world like none that you've ever known, the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you. Exploring things you never dare, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. Of the sky. And it's just when you've made a friend and all you know she's big, but you don't feel small. Someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead, your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you long for the things you know, and the world you left, and the world you own. The fun is done, you steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and you won't be alone. There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky. Good fortune, sir. Look what I have here. 5 gold pieces.
5 gold pieces?
I had more, but my mother made me surrender them. She gave me these 5 to do with as I please.
Oh my.
So, where's Mookie White?
She is back at home with my wife.
Let's go find her.
No, wait. I'm not certain that I wish to sell.
You said I might buy her back.
Yes, I'm just not certain that 5 gold pieces will...
Are you saying that you need more money?
More money is always good.
Keep this and I'll go fetch more.
No, wait, I didn't mean Five gold pieces? Why, with 5 gold pieces, I could buy baking supplies for a year. I could buy a thatched roof and
a chimney. But you buy yourself a child.
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious, but when explained, I'm delirious. Now, could you buy yourself a chop?
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a chop? 5 gold pieces, 10, 20?
Have not thought to put a price on it.
Of course you haven't. You haven't thought about a lot now, have you, sir?
Wait, give me back, that's not yours!
Nor is it Jack's. But that's not what's important. What's important is that your wish be honored.
Wait, you come back here, that money isn't yours, it's mine!
Damn!
What are you doing here?
You've the cape!
Yes, I've the cape. Only 2 of the items left to locate.
3.
2. I've the cow and the cape.
You've the cape!
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away. I never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to have entrusted her with you.
Well, she might just as easily have run from you.
But she didn't.
But she might have.
But she didn't.
Who cares? The cow is gone. Get it back. Get it back.
We were just going to do that. Here, I can give you this.
No! I don't want to touch that fool. Have you no sense?
Oh, did you hear the music? Oh, By tomorrow's midnight, deliver the items or you wish that you never thought to have a child.
I don't like that woman.
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
I shouldn't have yelled. Now please, return home. I will make things right. And then we can just go about our lives. No more rummaging about the woods for strange objects. No more witches or dim-witted boys or hungry little girls or... Go.
Ah, there you are, good brother. Father and I had wondered where you had gone. I have been searching all night. Her, the beautiful one I danced the evening with. She was lovely.
The loveliest.
I am not certain of that. You see, I must confess, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here, in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, in the top of a tall tower that has no doors or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues from here, due east, just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage a visit?
I stand beneath her window and say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And then she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climbed.
Rapunzel? What kind of a name is that? My brother, you jest. I never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She is as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince? None would run from us.
Yet one has. Did I abuse her, show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, shall I regain this heart she has won from me? Agony, beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in a tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blithe and becoming, frequently humming a light-hearted air. As intriguing
or half so fatiguing
as what's out of reach.
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome and heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Do I know the girl must be mad?
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her. Agony,
misery,
whoa, though it's different for each.
Always 10 steps behind,
always 10 feet below, and she's just out of reach. Agony. Cut like a knife. I must have her to
young boy with carrot top hair and a sunny
He's the one!
Have you seen the cow?
No, I don't care to ever again. Children can be very queer about their animals.
You be careful with your children.
I have no children. That's okay too.
Yes, well, I've not seen your son today.
Oh, well, I hope he hasn't gone up that beanstalk again.
Quit while you're ahead, I say.
Jack! Jack!
Move! Move!
Move! Looking for your cow?
Where did you find her? I've been looking all over for her. Hello?
Compare this to your corn.
Where did you find it?
Oh, I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Three!
And I almost had the fourth, but she got away.
Well, we've one entire day left. Surely we can locate the slipper by then.
We? You mean, you'll allow me to stay?
Well, perhaps it will take the two of us to get this child.
You've changed. You're daring. You're different in the woods. More sure. More sharing. You're getting us through. Then steal it. Just 2 days ago, you were accusing me of exercise. exercising deceit in securing the cow.
Then don't steal it! And resign yourself to a childless life.
I feel it best if you go for the cow, as I have met a maiden these previous years who has a golden slipper, and I think I might succeed in winning one of her shoes.
Fine.
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 That is simply fine!
Fine!
Unfortunately for Rapunzel, the witch discovered her affection for the prince before he could spirit her away.
What did I clearly say? Children should listen.
No, no, please!
What were you not to do? Children must see, and learn. Why could you not obey? Children should listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be?
To take the prince by surprise.
Boo!
And as I looked from the tower, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from her final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought, what would be his response? And then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he was? And then what if you are? What a prince, what a vision. Although, how can you know?
We only need one.
Yes.
you no good. If he's safe, then he's safe. If he's not, well, there's nothing any of us can do about that now, is there? I must be off. I need my rest before tomorrow's search to commence.
Doesn't anyone care that a giant has fallen from the sky?
Well, he's dead, is he not?
With such a thought, I should suppose.
Third Midnight is here. You've all the objects.
Yes, the slipper, hair.
Cape cow.
That cow doesn't look as white as milk to me.
Oh, she is. She is.
That cow has been covered with flour.
We had a white one, we did.
Where is she?
She's dead.
We thought you'd prefer a live one.
Of course I'd prefer a live one. So go get me the dead one, and I will bring it back to life.
Do that.
Now.
Son, there you are. I've been worried sick about you.
Mother, look. It's the most beautiful harp.
Ooh. You've stolen too much.
You could have been killed coming down that plant.
She's too heavy.
What's happening? Milky White, now I have two friends, a cow and a harp.
White, feed the objects to the cow.
What?
You heard me.
Here, I'll do it. She'll only milk for me. Squeeze, pal.
Wrong ingredients. Forget about a child.
Now you wait just one moment. We followed your instructions. One, that cow was as white as milk, correct? And two, the cape was as certainly as red as blood.
Yes.
And three, the slipper.
Yes.
And four, the hair was as yellow as this corn.
Yes, I pulled it from a maze in the tower.
You what? What were you doing there?
Well, I just happened to be passing by.
I touched that hair. I cannot touch the ingredients. Don't you understand?
No.
The corn.
What?
The silky yellow hair of the corn. Pull it from a stalk and feed it to the cow quickly.
Man, your son's gonna be the last of your flesh and blood.
Son? Not now.
Oh, meet your father.
Father, could that be you? I thought you died in a baking accident. I didn't want to leave you, son.
It's working.
She's melting. I don't understand. I lost her now. Quickly into the cup. We're giving you what you wish.
How long can we expect a child?
What's happening?
Florinda's room.
girl begged Saul in her pain, and joined the prince on his horse, to ride off to become his new wife.
I could be so proud. I wish.
And the baker and his family.
No, I miss.
I wish.
More than anything.
More than goblins.
There he is.
I wish to sponsor a festival.
More than life.
The time has come for a festival.
More than riches.
I miss my kingdom under the sky.
More than anything.
I wish we had more food.
Another room.
But despite some minor inconveniences, they were all content.
I never thought I'd wed a prince.
I never thought I'd find perfection.
I never thought I could be so happy. Not an unhappy moment since.
I didn't think we'd be this rich, conceivable objection.
I never thought we'd have a baby.
I never thought I could be so happy.
We are moving.
And so the baker proceeded to the castle, but not before paying a visit to Jack and his mother.
Look, mother, it's the butcher.
Baker.
What can we do for you, sir?
I'm here to investigate the destruction that was brought upon our house today.
Jack has been at home with me all day.
The baker told Jack and his mother that he feared there was a giant around.
I can recognize a giant's footsteps. I can find him.
Mama, honey, we'll do no such thing.
Well, any help at all.
I'm sorry, but you will get none from us. No one cared when there was a giant in my backyard. And I don't remember you coming to our aid.
A dead giant in your backyard is one thing, and a crushed home is quite another.
Look, young man, giants never strike the same house twice. I wouldn't worry if I were you.
I am taking the news to the castle nonetheless.
When the baker reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, madam, for this small man insists on seeing you.
Princess, I've come to report the appearance of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see it.
Then how do you know there is a giant in the land?
Because our house was trampled and there are footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I will show you to the door.
Wait.
A nearby house was visited by a giant not long ago, descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
That giant was slain. Now, come along.
Wait, please! Princess, we have a small child at home, and our small child was very hard to come by. His safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
Yes.
I will take this news up with the prince when he returns. Thank you. I'm going off to sell the harp, Jack.
Mother, no!
Please, we don't want anything around here where there are giants on the loose!
But I know how to kill a giant!
Because we have had our fill of giants!
But mother, please, just...
Promise me so that you will not leave your surroundings!
But mother, I'm a man now!
You are still a little boy in your mother's eyes now. I want you to promise me. Promise!
I promise.
What happened to your house?
We had a baking accident.
Baking accident?
No use frightening the young thing.
You can't frighten her.
Well, I guess Granny will have to do without the bread and sweets. Besides, I have all I can carry.
Why such a load?
Oh, I'm moving in with Granny. We had an accident too. I came home to find our house collapsed, as if a big wind blew it in. I couldn't find my mother anywhere.
Oh no.
So I salvaged what I could, and now I'm off.
Oh, good friends! What news have you? What of Mother's grave? What kind of trouble? Oh no! I can't investigate. A princess is not supposed to go into the woods unescorted. Good idea. I will disguise myself and go see what is wrong. Thank you, Bert.
We'll take you to Granny's.
What?
I'm not going to let her go alone.
All right. I will take you to your grandmother's.
Oh, I don't need anyone to take me. I've gone many times before.
But not when there have been such winds blowing about.
That's right. We'll all take you.
No.
I'm not going to stay here with the baby when there's a certain wind blowing about that might come back to our house, too.
I know my mother made me promise, but I'm going to find that giant anyway.
Into the woods, it's always when you think at last you're through, and then into the woods you go again to take another turn.
Into the woods, the weather's clear, we've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods, away from here.
Into the woods to find a giant.
Straight,
no reason then to hesitate.
are you doing here? What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. You just locked me away in a tower without company for all of my life, then blinded my prince and banished me to a desert where I had little to eat, and again, no company. Then poor twins. Because of the way you treated me, I will never, ever be happy.
I was just trying to be a good mother. Stay with me. There's a giant running about.
No soul could predict. I know not what to do. What a pity. And Cinderella.
She remains well.
Does she? Now, brother, do tell me what you're really doing here.
High in a tower like yours was, but high, a beauty asleep. All round the tower, thickets of briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen. When the one thing you want is the thing that you've not even seen.
I've found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it. Maiden last, just as unwakeable, what unmistakable agony is the way always barred. She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard. Agony, such that princes must weep. Always enthralled, most to anything, almost as something asleep.
If it were not for the thickets.
A thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest.
The quickest is pick it apart with a stick.
Yes, well, even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves? Dwarves are very upsetting.
Not forgetting the tasks unachievable, mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable, but unavailable.
Agony, misery.
Whoa, not to know what you miss.
While they lie there for years,
and you cry on their beers.
What unbearable bliss. Back to my wife. Rapunzel, I must be off. Godspeed to you, brother.
Godspeed.
And after hours of searching for bread, our intrepid travelers lost not only their way, but their patience as well.
Are you certain this is the right way?
We went down the dell. Perhaps you forgot the way, but the path is straight.
Was straight, now there is no path.
Where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down.
turn back. No!
We will just have to find Granny's without the path.
But Mother warned me to never stray from the path.
The path has strayed from you.
Wait, that looks familiar. See out from the distance, three oak trees.
Yes, I recognize them.
Who might that be?
There. We are almost there.
It's the steward of the royal family. What brings you into the woods?
The castle has been set upon by a giant.
Oh no.
I warned you. Why didn't you do anything?
I don't make policy. I simply carry it out.
And I warned you not to trust the royal family to solve all your problems. I think it best if we turn back to the village. I wouldn't be in such a rush if I were you. Guess which path the giant took to the castle? No.
What?
All that's left of my house is a sack of beads. And there's not much left of your house either.
No, no, I was told that a giant never strikes the same house twice.
You heard wrong.
Shh.
Here's the lad!
I'm not the lad! This is
not the way!
Don't try! Why did you push him into her arms?
You wanted to get rid of him too. We might have thought of something else. If it was up to you, a decision would never be made.
Now that he's gone, we will never know what happens next.
We'll manage.
Must I search amongst you for the lead?
No! That is just a boy! We had no food to eat, and he sold his beloved cow in exchange for beans! If anyone is to be punished, it's the man who made that exchange!
That's right!
Nonsense!
He was your responsibility! Now I must punish him for his wrongs!
We suffer too! Do you think it was a picnic?
You're getting me angry!
What about our anger? What about our loss? Who has been collapsing from our kingdom?
Shh, be quiet.
No, no, I will hide my son and you'll never find him.
Don't upset the giant.
You will never, never find him.
I'm warning you.
And you, if you don't go back this instant to where you came from,
where is your son?
The boy is hiding in the Siebel Tower.
That's true.
Yeah. If he is not, I will return and find you.
Rapunzel, stay away from me! No!
No! Don't step on!
Oh, she's in poor condition.
Wake up.
Don't let them get Jack.
We won't.
As I stand here at death's door, please, don't let them get Jack.
I'll do all I can.
Promise me.
Promise!
All right, I promise.
No, no, you come away from there. You killed her!
I was thinking of the greater good. That's my job.
This is the world I meant. Couldn't you listen?
And now this. When are things going to return to normal?
We must be gone if we're to arrive before midnight.
Where are you going?
We are going to a special kingdom.
Shh! We can't take everyone. Fools! There is nowhere to hide.
No. No. You can't go. You'll never make it in time. You have to stay here with us, and we'll figure this out together.
Some people are cut out to battle giants, and others are not. I don't have the constitution, and as long as I'm of no help, I'm going to hide. Everything will work out fine in the end.
No. Not always.
I hope the giant steps on them all.
You shouldn't say that. You were thinking the same thing.
This is terrible. We just saw three people die.
How many wolves have you carved up? Since when are you so squeamish?
A wolf is not the same.
Ask a wolf's mother.
Stop it!
We must give someone to the giant.
If we give her the boy, she'll kill him too.
And if we don't, she'll kill half the kingdom.
One step at a time. Maybe if he apologizes, makes amends.
Yes, yes, he'll return the stolen goods.
Yes,
yes, he's a really sweet boy at heart. She'll see that. You people are so blind! It's because of this boy there's a giant in our kingdom. And while you continue talking about the problem, I'll go find the lad and serve him to the giant for lunch.
Are we gonna let her feed the boy to the giant?
No.
I'll just have to find the boy first.
I'll go too.
No, you will stay here with the baby.
We'll fan out. We'll increase our chances of finding him. No, you stay here with the baby. I do not want you roaming about in the woods.
You would leave our child with her?
Yes, the baby is asleep. He'll be safe with the girl.
But what if the giant were to return here?
The giant will not harm them, I know.
How do you know?
I know.
But what if the giant...
But what if? Well, only a giant foot stop your arguing!
You stay here with the baby. Please.
Do you two always argue like that?
No, not really.
Seems like you do.
And there's nothing wrong with having an argument.
Oh, I see.
Milky! Milky!
That's him! Jack! Jack!
Milky!
Stay here.
But I must come.
No, you'll be safer here.
Don't go too far. Please.
I will only go 100 paces. If I don't find the lad, I'll come back. One, two, three, Jack! Jack!
Right.
right and wrong don't matter in the woods. Only feelings let us meet this moment unblushed. Life is often so unpleasant. You must know that as a peasant, best to take the moment present as a present for the moment.
Service?
The tree has fallen. Mother's grave destroyed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
My wishes have just been crushed.
Don't say that.
It's true, you wouldn't understand.
Well, you can't stay here. There's a giant on the loose. It's not safe.
I'm certain the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our land.
There's been no sign of the prince. No doubt he's off seducing some young maiden.
What?
I understand that's what princes do.
Not all princes.
Come to think of it, you look just like the princess, but dirty. Oh, you are the princess.
Please, get up. I'm not a princess here.
Well, what are you to do?
I must be on my way back to the castle.
You haven't heard? We came upon the royal family in the woods. The castle was set upon by a giant.
And the prince?
He was not with them. Here, come with me. You'll be safe in our company.
For those moments in the woods. Oh, witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment you can't live in the world. And again, what you wish only just for a moment, these are dangerous words. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had a hand when you're back to war makes the or mean more than it did before. Now I understand, and it's time to leave the world.
Be
always give her the boy.
No.
No. No, of course it really matters. It's the blame. Someone you can blame. Fine, if that's the thing you enjoy, placing the blame. If that's the aim, give me the blame. Just give me the boy. No. No. You're so nice. You're not good. You're not bad. You're just nice. I'm not good. I'm not nice. I'm just right. I'm the witch. You're the world. I'm the hitch. I'm what no one believes. I'm the witch. You're all liars and thieves. Like his father, like his son, will be too. Oh, why bother? You'll just do what you do with the last midnight. So goodbye, all. Coming at you.
Because of you, all of this happened. I strayed into the garden that night to get your mother a gift. And I foolishly took some of those beans for myself. How was I to know? How are we ever to know? And when your mother died, I was scared and I ran away. And now aren't you doing the same thing?
No, no, I am not.
Aren't you running away?
No more questions, please. No more tests. Comes the day you say what for. Just no more.
We did.
no more jests. No more curses you can't undo, left by fathers you never knew. No more quests. No more feelings. Time to shut the door.
Giant returns, they'll attack her and peck out her eyes till she's blind. What will that do?
Then we can surprise her, strike her, or whatever it is you do to kill a giant.
Once she's blinded, she'll just stumble about.
She'll get angry.
And then she'll crush us all. Smear the ground with pitch. We'll lure her to an area smeared with pitch. Her shoes will get stuck and she won't be able to move.
And I can strike her from behind.
Strike her from behind how? And lure her where?
Yes, where?
A tower. An old one between the two trees.
Yes, we'll send her to the tower.
All right, we have to try something before she returns. Quick, let's do this before nightfall.
Here.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm excited.
Come on.
My darling, I did not recognize you. What are you doing in those old clothes? And with a child? You must go back to the castle at once. There's a giant on the loose.
The giant has been to the castle.
No! Are you all right? My love, why are you being so cold?
Maybe because I'm not your only love, am I?
I love you. I do. But yes, it's true.
If you love me, why would you have strayed?
I thought that if I could have you, I would never ask for more. And part of me is as happy and content as I've ever been. But a part of me remains. That continually asks for more.
I have on occasion wanted more, but that does not mean I went in search of it. If this is how you behave as a prince, what kind of king will you be?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. I didn't ask to be born a king. And I'm not perfect. I'm only human.
Please go.
Leave? But I do love you.
Consider that I have been lost, a victim of the giant.
Is that what you really wish?
My father's house was a nightmare. Your house was a dream. But now I want something in between. Please go.
I will always love the maiden who ran away.
And I, the faraway prince.
They're almost finished. You see over there between those two towers? When the giant comes, we're to send her over there.
Good. I wanted to climb the tower too. I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong?
My granny's gone. I think my granny and my mother will be very upset with me.
Why?
They told me to always make them proud, and here I am about to kill somebody.
Not somebody. A giant who has been doing harm.
But the giant's a person. Already show forgiveness? Mother would be very unhappy with these circumstances.
Thank you.
my mother has heard I've slain a giant.
Jack. Your mother's dead.
Dead? Was she killed by the giant?
No, she was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you. But then she was struck a deadly blow by the Princess Stuart.
Why would he do that?
He thought she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No.
The Stuart must pay for what he's done. As soon as I slay the giant, I will then slay him.
He'll do nothing of the kind.
Why not?
Because that would be wrong.
Isn't what he did wrong?
Yes, yes it is, and he'll pay for it somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I cannot answer.
I'm gonna kill him.
Fine. Kill him. Wait. Don't kill him.
one straight rope.
The harder to wait, the better to act.
Halfway through the world, do not let it grieve you. No one leaves. Thank you.